Hey folks, it's Will from MinIO, and I'm here with a little how-to video on connecting to MinIO with JavaScript. We're actually going to be using Node version 18 and play.min.io to connect to, and our development environment is going to be VS Code. So let's go ahead and dive right into our example. If you want to use MinIO with your Node.js based application, the first thing you're going to want to do is include that in a dependency in your package.json file. And as you can see here, I've written up just a very simple package.json here. But the key that you want to look at is here on line 15, this dependencies with MinIO that is compatible with 7.0.32. And that's just because that's what we're running on play.min.io, so that we'll be able to connect to it. The rest of this is all standard boilerplate for your package.json. And then what we're going to do is here in our index.js, which is our main file, we are going to connect to MinIO. So you will need to import with this require statement, var MinIO require MinIO. I've also got this MinIO demo functions file. Don't worry too much about that right now. It's just so that we can actually see something happening. So what we're going to do is we're going to create this MinIO client variable out of our MinIO import using the client constructor. And here in the client constructor, there's some options that we need to hand in. First off, we need our endpoint, which is play.min.io. We have to set our port, which is going to be 9000. That's kind of the default port. We are using SSL for this connection. And as you can see, we have an access key and a secret key. Now, the access key, secret key, these are common to play.min.io. If you want to go out to play.min.io and log in, you can use that as your username and password. And so what we're going to do is we are then going to list the buckets that are available out on play.min.io. In order to get this all running, you need to use npm to install the MinIO libraries. So that's just a very simple here in our terminal. We're going to do an npm install MinIO. And that's going to go out. It's going to install a bunch of dependencies as well. And when we run this, it's actually going to build that node packages and all that other fun stuff for us. We even are going to have a package lock file here in our demo directory that includes all of that information. I'm going to go ahead and run this index.js with node index.js. And when I run this, there are a number of buckets that have already been created out on play.min.io. If you run this code yourself, if you want to run code like this yourself, what you're going to see is you're probably going to see a different list because these buckets get collected on a regular basis. Play.min.io is really just a sandbox environment. Stuff gets deleted off of play.min.io on a regular basis. So all of this fun bucket list that we have is going to change depending on when you run it. But there you go. That's everything you need to know about connecting to your MinIO instance. All you need is this client constructor with the right variables set up, and just make sure that your package is going to include this MinIO dependency so that you can get all of the details that you want to have. And that's everything that we have for this particular how-to. So with that, if you want to connect with us, feel free to reach out to any of the different platforms you see here. MinIO.slack.com is a great public Slack page that you can connect with us at any time, ask any questions you want. And of course, you can always reply to this particular video and give us any comments below. Thanks for joining us for this how-to. We'll see you in the next one.